Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are doing fine. Children, we are going to start up a new topic today, and it's one of the very interesting topic you would definitely enjoy, and that is duck's paint. So let us get started with duck's paint. So the screen which you are able to see on your screen is the duck's paint app. What it is, Tux Paint. With the name only, you can understand that this is a painting app. So Tux Paint is one of the program. Tux Paint is an easy to use program which is used to create beautiful drawings. Yes. So let us just see some components of the main screen of your Tux Paint. So this is what your Tux Paint screen looks like. At the left hand side here, you will be able to see toolbar. At the right hand side, you have selectors. Center white part is our drawing canvas. And below the canvas, you can see color tools where you can find so many different of the colors. And below that, we have something called help area. Let us see here. See this side, left side of your Tux Paint is your tools. At the right side is your selectors. See, I know it is written it as brush tools, brush, but it keeps changing with the different tools. See, now here it is paint, that's why it is brushes. If I click on stamp, it's stamp. Can I, if I click on lines, it's brush again. Shapes, to shape again. Text, letters. So whatever tool you're going to click at the left hand side, children, right hand side, the brushes will be changing, the options will be changing. So these are the options from which you're going to select. That's the reason this side, right side of your text paint is called as selector. Now down here, you can see so many colors. Just follow my mouse pointer, children. So below this white portion here, you have color palette. So whatever color you want to paint on, you can select it from here. So from black, gray, ash, white, red, orange, yellow, green, pista green, then you have green, you have somewhere around lightish purple, then you have brinjal color, then you have lavender, you have purple, you have pink, you have brown, you have beige, you have white. And besides that, you can see some color here, which shows black. If you click on this, you will get so many different colors. So from these colors, you can select anything, whichever you want. Now, how should I close this? Can you see a black back button here? Click on this, you will come back. Okay. And below this, you can see one, our monkey, right? Our monkey is here, chimpanzee. So what does he do? He keeps on helping us about the different tool options. Now, when I've clicked on paint, it is telling me pick a color and brush shape. So he's telling pick a color. Let me pick a red color. And he said me to take a brush. I do have many brushes. Can you see a down arrow here? Click on that. See, it will keep on changing. So I'll take this color brush. See, I'm clicking here and there. It's just a mouse click. Can you see? See here my screen. I am going to change. See here. Yes. This is the way you will do it. Yes. I've clicked on paint tool. It said me pick a color and a brush shape to draw with it. So if I draw, see here. Yes. So this is what your Tux Paint screen looks like. Left hand side, whatever tools, these are the tools. Right hand side, the options which are able to see are called as selector. The white portion is our canvas area. Canvas is the paper on which you paint. Below that you have colors, yes. And below that is your chimpanzee, which keeps you guiding with what is supposed to be done. Let me see, let me click on stamp. Let me see what chimpanzee is going to tell me. I'm clicking on stamp. Pick a picture to stamp around your drawing. So pick any picture from here and stamp it. Let me take this chimpanzee. See, take this one. See? Yes, this is the way. You can just click here and come and click on the canvas area. You will be able to take whatever images you have it on your stamp side. Yes. So let me undo and find. Children, let us go to one tools one by one. So here I am with our first tool named as paint tool. So paint tool, can you just see how does it look like? It looks like a brush one, right? You can see an image of brush. That means we have to use different brushes. And let us come towards the selector side. Can you see there is an upper arrow mark and below that you have another called down arrow mark. That means if you click on down, you can see different brush shapes. Isn't it, children? Yes, yeah. So keep clicking on this one and you will be able to see so many different types of brushes. Yes, let me go up, try a few brushes. Keep clicking, okay? I'll take a small one. See how the line is. I've taken a red color. Let me take a green color and I'll increase the brush size. Can you see? Yes. I'll take a shade side. I'll take brown. See how the painting is happening? Let me take a triangle and I'll change the color to blue. See, I can keep doing. It is giving me triangle, right? Let me take this one and I'll take a orange color. Can you see how it is getting painted? Yes. Let us change some more. Let me take this one and I'll change the color to purple. It's like splashing colors, isn't it? Okay, let me take this grid and I'll take a... No, I'll take a red color again, see? How nice it is looking. Let me take a cat and I'll take a purple color for it. See how the cat... When I'm just dragging, see, can you see cats, different shape? So we can make different borders and shades here and there whenever we are using. So let me go somewhere down. Okay, I'll take the spiral. And what color shall we take it? Let us take yellow color. No, it's not visible at all. I can take this. See? I'll take this small squirrel. We'll take squirrel as a brown color. Let's see. See how squirrel's different position it's showing me. And let me take this grass. And I'll take a green color. And I will click. See how nicely I'm getting this grass. Isn't it really nice? Yes. So we have different types of, from the selector portion, I'll take the spear also. Let me do with the spear also. Can you see how nice it is looking? Yes. Let me... I have done this one. I'll take a new page. I will tell you how to do a new page and everything one by one. I've taken a new. See, I'm taking a spear. Either I can do a plain line or I can just keep clicking here and there. Yes? Or let me take this one. I'm taking a red color. See? Yes. On a triangle and take a different color here and there. this is how children you are going to be using your brush tool. So this is, that is nothing but paint tool. So click on the paint tool, and from the brush side, from the selector side, select any shape of your brush and then keep using it on your screen. So with just with those, so with just with the brush tool, shall we make a plant here? Yes, I am going to make a plant. So let me take a new paper. Okay, let me, I am going to take a thicker tool. I'm taking this one. Can you just see I am making the trunk of the tree? So for that I need a thick brush I've taken. Then I'll take a smaller brush. With that I'm going to make branches. Though big branches. Yes. Yes. Now I'll reduce the brush size so that I'll make small, small more branches here. Yes. See, so many. Children, can you just see I am changing the brush size also, right? I'm selecting different type of brushes as per my requirement. See? Yes. Now my tree with the trunk and everything is ready. I want to give little patches over here. So I'll take this one and I'll take black color, and I am bringing the patch. Sometimes you can see such patches on the plants, right? Now what will I do? I'll take again a plant. I will go to this tool. Can you see? I have a green color plant here. I'll take this green and I'll start putting. So this is how I am going to be doing, and I'll change little yellow color. I'll go for little yellow color or light shade, because plants have different shades of leaves also, right? Light green, dark green, somewhere yellows which are getting dried here and there, correct? So I will be doing, so I'll take a yellow color. I will change the color here, little lighter yellow I'll take. Yes. And I will put the light yellow shade here and there. See how nice my plant is looking. Let me make it a little more shadier. So I am going to take brown color, and I'm going to be doing yes, again, let me take a green color. How, see, you will be drawing as per your choices, right? Yes, see? Yes, this is how I made my tree. Isn't it looking like a real tree, children? Just using the paint tool and using different types of brushes, I made this particular painting. The green. So if we want to put some flowers, I'll take a small one and I'll take red colors and put here and there one flower. Or take this kind of a flower and put here and there. See how beautiful painting did I make? Yes. This is how you can do the painting. So paint tool is like a pencil or a brush. It looks like a pencil or a brush. This tool can be used for freehand drawing, children. When paint tool is selected, the selector toolbar displays several different types of brushes which we can use it for our freehand drawing. So what are the steps to do it? Click on the paint tool from the toolbar, choose the brush from the selector, pick any color from the box and put the cursor on the canvas and start drawing it. This is how you will be able to use the paint tool. Yes. And let us take another tool today. So children, either you can go for a new drawing. One thing. Okay. Now I have done this drawing. I want to go for a new page. Either I can directly go for the new page or you want to rub it. You can go to eraser tool. From eraser tool, you have at the selector side, can you see? Once I clicked on eraser tool, at the selector side, you can see different sizes of erasers are available. If you take a bigger one, can you see here how the how my mouse pointer has turned into a square shape? Yes. Likewise, you can just keep start rubbing it, or you want a smaller portion to be erased. Take a small box, you have more small box, you have more dotted box, which you can see here, I am doing it. Or you want in a circular portion, do it. Or take a small circular portion, yes. Or if, and now one more thing, you might have a question on your mind saying that, madam, I want to save this, whatever I have done it. Can we save it on TextMate? Yes, children, can you see here in the toolbar? At the second line here, save button. So if you click on save button, your picture gets saved. Now where will you be able to see this one? Can you see beside the save button, you have something called open. Click on open. See yours, but your plant has got saved here. I have done so many different types of pictures. Solar system, bat and ball, moon, rocket launching, everything. So I'll be teaching you everything. Yes. So now either you can take an eraser to and start erasing it, or simply take a new one. So we will go for new one. So let's click on new one. Once you click on new canvas, children, you will have so many options in front of you. Can you see here? Either you want white color canvas, black color canvas, gray, a lighter shade of gray, red, green, and you can see a down arrow mark, click on. See, so many different styles of canvas paper. You want ready-made pictures? See here, we have a vulture, we have castle, we have tortoise, we have a hen, we have fish, elephant, some frames. Let us see some more different types of frames. Grid is there, crocodile, hat, aeroplane, car, skull, flower, rocket. See, so many different. If you want some nature background, see here, we have tractors, we have different design. So we have different maps also here. So whichever background you want to go for, you can click it. And let us take an example. I will take this house, or I'll take this one. It's like a jungle. And I'll double click on this. Can you see? A nice farm of crop, it is there. I can use it for my benefit or for my background. Yes. So let me take a plain background because we want to do some painting. So I'll take white background only. This is my white background ready. Now we will be concentrating on the second tool in our toolbar. What is it? Is line tool. Once I click on line tool, see my brushes are also at the selector side, we have the brushes. So here I'll take whatever size of brush. Let me take a thick brush and see. It will allow me to put a line. Like this. If I take a triangle, yes, now this flower, a cat, I'll take a green cat. Can you see? So what is the benefit of having this line tool? This tool allows you to draw straight lines using various brushes and colors. Selector offers many options for this tool, which can be used after selecting the tools. So for that, what are you supposed to do? Let me erase everything using the eraser tool. Now I'll click on line tool. From the brushing option, whatever shape you want to, let me take this spiral. Okay, so click on the line tool from the toolbar, then from the selector, select the desired brush. I'm taking a spiral, and you choose any color. Let me take this purple color, and then come to the canvas area and press mouse, left mouse button, and drag the mouse. I'm pressing. See, children, I've kept, can you see on my screen? I have kept my left mouse button pressed, and I'm going to drag the line and leave the button. It will get covered. Let me take a star, and I'll take another color. So I'll take a straight line down. See? And let me take the shade, a darker one. See how the lines are being drawn? Let me take this one. Can you see? See how we are able to use. So what is the, basically what can we do with this? Let me erase it again. And I can make borders using these kind of lines. So let me, I want to make a border of this green color grass with orange color. So what will I do? I'll start my paint like this. See here. See how nice the border has come up. With this, let me make some squirrels also of gray color. See? Yes, this is how you can use the different line tools, children. With this, you can make any kind of borders, backgrounds, yes, maybe some fences, correct? When you're making some houses, you can make fences. Now, if you do a mistake, what you're supposed to do, go and click on eraser tool and select the shape of, I'll take a circle now. See, my eraser is getting erased using the circle shape. Yes, this is how you can do different paints using paintbrush, and using the line tools, you can make different types of lines. Yes, eraser tool, if you want to use it, click on eraser toolbar, come at the selector side. From the selector side, select the size of the, okay, imagine I just want to see, now if I rub this one, it, a big portion is getting rubbed. So I want to take a small, I want to just rub a small squirrel. So for that, I'll take a smaller rubber. It is just like how you use rubber on your books. If you want to make a, erase a bigger portion, take a bigger rubber eraser. And if you want to erase a smaller portion, take a smaller eraser. That will help you very nicely. So I want to erase a bigger portion, so I'll take a bigger one, and let me erase it very fast. This is how it about your eraser. Yes. Now let us go towards our text tool. Can you see the third tool here? Text. Text tools. And at the right hand side, you can see different styles of text are available. Yes. Yes. So whatever style you want to use it, let me use this one, and come whichever color you want to use it, use that one from the color palette, select the colors. Let me see what chimpanzee is telling me. Choose a style of text, yes. Click on your drawing and you can start typing. Okay, let me use this one, I'll put it. Class, it's a different, I'll take this one. I'll put it as class. four students are very intelligent. Yes, nice, right? So whatever painting you do, you can give any title to it, or you can write your name. Let me write it. So I will open my old drawing. I will write my name here, painted by Premlata. I'll take this one. Painted by Premlata. Now I'll save it again. See, now it got saved. Yes, this is how you can give the names to the painting, whichever you do. So text tool here is used to type a statement or to give a heading to the scenery. Yes, so how, let us just recall what are the different steps here. Click on text tool from the toolbar. Select the size or the style of the letters from the selector side, and then choose any color which you want to get it written, and come to the canvas area and start typing. This is how you can actually do typing on your painting. So for today, we have completed about paintbrush, line, text tool, eraser, and new tool. Correct? And further, other more tools are available in your TuxPaint. So we will be seeing in our next class. Children, whoever is having computer at your house, please download TuxPaint from the internet and use it on your computer and do practice this painting. It is amazing tool, and you can create beautiful painting using this particular application. I will be back again with a new video with the further tools. Bye bye.